Quaden Bales is 4 years old, and this little boy from Brisbane is a powerhouse. He's inspiring an amazing campaign to raise awareness about dwarfism. He's already been through several bouts of surgery with plenty of support from celebrities like this famous singer.
Hey, Quady, it's Guy Sebastian here. Just wanted to say good luck for your surgery today. I hope it all goes well. Peace out.
Oh. And Quaden Bales and his mum, Yuraka, join us now from Brisbane. Welcome to the show. Now, Quaden has a form of dwarfism. How does that affect his body exactly?
Yeah, so Quaden was born with achondroplasia. It's the most common form of dwarfism. Obviously, it's a bone dysplasia, so it's a stunted growth condition which affects majorly these four bones that don't grow at the same rate as the other bones in his body. So the average height of someone with dwarfism is around 4 foot, but it varies.
Yuraka, he looks very cute, but he has spoken out about people staring at him, and you posted a video of him that went viral.
Yeah, I posted that on the 1st of October last year, which was Dwarfism Awareness Month, and that's when things started changing for us. So every day in public can become quite challenging. It's not all the time. There are some really lovely people out there that show their support, but you're always going to get the odd one that, you know, tries to point his differences out. And I actually was just walking along in a shopping centre and a group of girls would stop and then they'd tell a friend, and then it ended up being a few other people, and they were all just pointing and staring and making it quite obvious. So I just thought I'd, you know, put the phone on record, and it just looked like I was on the phone. And it was just him saying, stop looking at me. He actually made me aware that they were looking and looking and looking because they were walking right behind us. And he said, like, at least 10 times, stop looking at me. And that's, he's quite aware of it, and it's not something that we make him aware of. It's just something that, you know, he can't escape, and it's, unfortunately, it's something we have to get used to.
Well, we'd like to show that video now. Let's take a look.
Stop looking at me.
What you do? It's okay.
I don't like
you. You don't like everybody looking at you?
Oh, yeah, I reckon we've just seen that video and it makes your heart break, and even more so for you, it must be hard. As a mum, what sorts of strategies do you put in place to make sure that your beautiful little boy doesn't take too much of that on board?
It's something fairly new to me, so I'm just learning, and the great thing is, with sharing our journey on social media, we've been able to get great advice and support from people with dwarfism all around the world. And as a single mum, you know, I'm still readjusting to life as a single mum and raising him. So I've reached out on social media and asked for support and advice, like, how do you guys handle the staring and, you know, like the name calling? He's had a couple of recent not so nice comments on Facebook, just commenting on his physical appearance. And it's quite tough, but you know what? We've raised him to be a strong, confident Aboriginal boy who just so happens to be born with dwarfism. And I think that's the best we can do, by just embracing differences, by letting everyone know, you know, that, yeah, we're all beautiful, we're all different, and we need to embrace and celebrate that.
Oh, good on you, Yuraka. And you have been doing an absolutely outstanding job of that yourself. And, of course, you've got a bunch of really high-profile celebrities and footy players who've gotten on board to say this isn't OK, because, God, it makes my blood boil when I see stuff like this. Tell us about that.
The support has just been amazing. It's been really overwhelming. We weren't really expecting anything at all. All I wanted to do was share our journey to help raise much-needed dwarfism awareness in Australia. And Quaden's a huge footy fan, so I just thought, you know, if there were people out there that could just help cheer him up, his journey in hospital. It's been weeks and weeks on end in hospital at times. And so a lot of his famous, favourite footy stars have just come on and said, you know, well, he spent his fourth birthday in hospital in December. For 2 weeks he was in ICU after surgery there.
Yeah, but what is the surgery for? What are they trying to do with this?
So the first, he had an MRI and standard procedures, which are the tubes in to drain fluid out of his ears, the adenoids out and tonsils out. So that makes room for them to breathe better. So he's got severe obstructive sleep apnea, which can cause a lot of pressure in the brain around the head. So most children with achondroplasia are born with hydrocephalus, which is apparent, the big head, but I say no, they're very smart, so it's the big brains that show with the big head. He's very highly intelligent. So he's had the MRI in December, and we actually got the news on his birthday that the MRI was showing the fluid and pressure, which is why they'd done the decompression surgery, which is also quite common for children with dwarfism. Because the big head pushes down on the spinal cord, he had a lot of bruising and swelling and intracranial pressure there. So that was 2 weeks ago. He had he was rushed in for emergency caesarean, emergency surgery. I had the emergency caesarean with him. That was 4 years ago. So he had the decompression surgery a fortnight ago, and just Wednesday, a few days ago, he had tonsils and adenoids out again and grommets put back in, and he'll be having another MRI. So we're just hoping and praying that the next results are a lot better. Unfortunately, the last surgery wasn't too well, so his oxygen levels are still really low because he stops breathing so much through the night. He sleeps with a CPAP machine on every night just to help with his breathing, and that's a bit of a struggle at the moment. Yeah. But, you know, above and beyond, like, he's doing really good for a four-year-old. He doesn't complain. He doesn't even take the pain relief in hospital. He doesn't like taking any medicine. He just puts up with it, and, you know, he's just a warrior. He's so strong, and I draw my strength from him. You know, I'm able to do it and share our story because he's so good, and it just makes it so much easier for me because he's such a good kid.
Oh, he certainly kept us entertained these last 4 minutes with that big, beautiful smile. I think Jess said it best as well, Yarika. You are such a remarkable mother, and you have so much strength. Thank you for joining us. The campaign is called Stand Tall. All the details are on our Facebook page. Make sure you get amongst it and be part of it. It is a great movement. Thank you so much for coming on the show, guys.
Thanks so much for having us.